time has come. For 300 years, we prepared. We grew stronger. While you rested in your cradle of power.
So I thought this was kind of funny, because once again, Funimation is making changes to shows. They've been doing this for a while. We've talked about this a couple of times, actually. Funimation changing anime more for the Puritan than the purist. It's a shame, because if you do want to watch a dub show, you don't know if you're getting a very good translation. Though this is really nothing new to Funimation. Look back to the old dub of Dragon Ball. Though there were a lot of reasons for that. They've claimed they were getting better. They seemed like they were for a while. And then, well, you know, the Vic stuff happened. And people really started to go through their stuff. But they were getting busted before that. Making changes, particularly with like Gamergate stuff and so on and so on. But they're doing it again. And this one is really baffling because this isn't even really that bad of a joke. But apparently you can't even have some light humor anymore. I mean, this is like grade school level stuff. So you have this anime here, BOFURI. I don't want to get hurt, so I'll max out my defense. And what's going on here? Basically, there was a tournament. This character came in third place, and they're asking her a question. You know, what happened? So we have both pairs of dialogue here. I'm going to go through them for you guys. And there's only one small change. That's the thing. But, you know, a change like this is enough to totally change the mood. So here's what happens. So I'm going to read you one full set of dialogue here, and that's the Japanese version. So here is the original Japanese version. The interviewer says, "Let's kick off our interviews with our third place winner, Maple." Maple says, "Huh?" Interviewer says, "Anything to say about the event?" And Maple says in a very nervous fashion, "I took a pounding, but I liked it." And then she does the anime trope where her face turns really red with embarrassment. Some steam comes out of her ears and stuff because she's embarrassed. And then the crowd says, did she just trip over her tongue? Crowd says, "She sure did."
"How dare you?"
How horrible, right? That was such an offensive line of dialogue. Trips over her words and then is embarrassed because, well, it sounds like she took a pounding out there. You can pretty much take that however you want to. Apparently that's too risque, too hardcore for Funimation. Got to change it. Don't want to upset any Puritans over on Twitter. Don't want to get them sad or offended. So we change it. Here's what we change it to. "So what are your thoughts about the event?" Maple responds, well, it was tough, but I'm happy." "Oh, did she just say happy?" "Sure did."
"What a story, Mark."
Personally, I don't find that anywhere near as good as the original version. If you watch it in subtitles, though, nothing changes. Apparently, though, if you want to hear this dialogue in English, you're out of luck. You have to get the Puritan version. So here's what I wonder. How many more changes like this are being done? You know, because people do catch them. But, you know, does everybody going through everything they put out? I just find this really strange. Like, what's so wrong with what was said before? It's very grade school level joke, as Bounded Into Comics points out in their write-up of this. So I'm just a little kind of confused here on this. But, you know, who are they making this for? I mean, most people that are watching this are old enough to handle a little etchy joke. I don't even think it was really... I mean, there's several ways you could have taken that original joke. It doesn't necessarily mean it was a sexual thing. But apparently that's the way they're going to take it. Well, don't want to upset those wokies out there. Don't want them to get a little butthurt about a little joke. So we better go ahead and change it anyway. Really sad. Funimation, I hate that they're the top dog in American anime. And I don't think anyone else can jump in and really kind of counter them. They really have a monopoly on the industry in the West. And it sucks. You really need to go to the Seven Seas if you want to get away from their power and stick the fan sub. So really sad to see. If you're a fan of this anime, now you know, hey, you better watch it in subtitles if you do feel the need to support Funimation, and I don't know why, watch it in subs. So I got one more thing And that's more Interspecies Reviewers news because another broadcasting station has canceled the show. Okay, so we're going to talk about Interspecies Reviewers one more time because now another outlet has dropped it. So here's what's going on. Let me give you a quick recap if you don't know what's going on with the show because it has been a bunch of drama with this show. So originally Funimation picked it up and they dropped it, swept it under a rug. They started dubbing it. They were subtitling it and showing it through simulcast dubbing. They canceled it and dropped it. Said, we're not going to show it anymore. And never really gave a reason why. They just swept it under a rug, even though they've done shows similar to it. Then Amazon Prime dumped it. And I think another outlet did as well. I think Anime Labs is one of the few places that you can watch it. I don't know about anywhere else legally. You'll probably have to sail the high seas now if you want to watch it, at least with subtitles. So in Japan, four broadcast stations were showing it on air. One of them dropped it, a big one, and now Sun TV has dropped it. So I believe there's only two other broadcast networks airing the show over there. And, you know, the way these things go, I would expect them to drop it as well. So it's really confusing. They've shown stuff like this before on air in Japan. I don't know if they're cracking down because they've gotten really super conservative more than usual lately about stuff. So I don't know if maybe that's what's going on or what, but this show is quickly on its way out the door. I don't know if there's much profit if it's not being shown. You know, they rely on the merchandise and I don't even know how much they're going to get if there's no exposure for the show. But either way, this is the tweet from them. Interspecies Reviewers, the broadcast on Sun Television has been canceled for the animated show Interspecies Reviewers due to public corporation Sun Television's organization circumstances. From here on, the broadcasting arrangements for Interspecies Reviewers has been discontinued. So if I'm right from the previous report on this, there's only two broadcasting networks still showing this show. I don't know anything about the ratings and what's going on over there, but this is just continuing what's already been happening. I would say this show's probably going to get on the chopping block, and it's a shame. From what I hear, it's pretty funny. I haven't watched it yet. I do plan to get around to it, but I wonder if it'll even finish now. Like, I don't even know if this show is going to finish by the way that they keep canceling it on networks. So I think there's only two more channels broadcasting it, and that's it. I don't know about streaming or whatnot. So who knows? This show might not make it very much longer. A lot of funny drama around this show. You had big YouTubers going to an anime website and ranking it up as the greatest anime of all time. And then they banned the YouTubers and made massive changes to their website. There's been some fun stuff revolving around this show, but it's just really strange the way everybody's acting about it. I don't get why we can't just all be adults and enjoy some naughty humor, but, you know, it's a Puritan world out there, isn't it? Anyway, that's pretty much it. Just a quick update. Funimation still doing their stupid editing and ruining shows. It's hard to watch them dub anyway. I have a hard time understanding Funimation when they talk, like their voice actors. I have a hard time understanding their voice actors when they talk because all I hear is a lot of hissing and slithering because it's a snake den over there. Bad joke. Anyway, that's it. Thanks for watching, guys. Let me know your thoughts on this. Are you watching BOFURI or this? What do you think? Do you think this show's on the chopping block? Are you tired of Funimation making these changes? I'd like to hear what you guys have to say. Also, share the video. Throw a like up. Make sure you're still subscribed. Subscribe if you're new. Hit that notification bell, and I'll see you guys on the next one. Peace. Also, if you want to help support the channel, check out my Teespring store. There's a link in the description. You can find some merchandise in there that you might want to check out.